Hello friends, I welcome you all. My name is Ritika Chaudhary and today we will discuss about leopard deaths in India. Listed as vulnerable, just short of endangered by a red list maintained by the International Union for Conservation of Nature. Leopard, with the scientific name Panthera pardus, is protected by Indian law and classified as needing the highest protection under the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. Leopards are India's most widespread big cats and a keystone species, their presence indicating the well-being of wild areas, forest and water sources, which sustain not just wildlife, but in spite of so much significance attached to the leopards, we are still facing a great threat to their survival. India lost at least 218 leopards over the first 4 months of 2019, more than 40% of the previous year's death toll of 500, which itself was the highest ever since the non-profit Wildlife Protection Society of India began keeping records in 2009. At least one leopard died every day in India. Trapped in wells, beaten or shot to death, run over on rail and road in 2018 only as per WSI data. As the death toll of India's most adaptable big cat rises to record levels, India is worried that leopard may now be more at risk of extinction than tigers. Today, we are losing far more leopards than tigers. Going by last year's figures, we are losing 5 leopards every 4 days. Yet, we do not have a database. States like Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka and Uttarakhand may have the data, but not all states do. Now the question arises, what is causing the death of leopards? To begin with, poachers are the leading cause of leopard deaths, claiming 26% of the cats between January and April 2019. In 2018, poachers killed 169 leopards, the highest since 188 in 2011, according to WPSI data. These data list 64 leopards poached in 2015, 83 in 2016, 47 in 2017, and 66 until October 2018. The WPSI data records 127 leopards killed by poachers in 2015, 154 in 2016, and 159 in 2017. An international trade in leopard parts drives the killing. There is a huge demand in China and other Southeast Asian countries for its skin, claws, and bones. Locally also, there is a small demand for its paws and canines, which are also used to perform black magic. The decimation of leopards is not reflected in official data. 260 leopards were poached between 2015 and October 2018. Some of the deaths tend not to be reported because forest officers, and who must do so, are also responsible for protecting leopards. In recent years, most deaths are reported as natural or territorial deaths, and very few are reported as poaching, because the failure of forest officer will tarnish their image, and so it is likely that they cover up such incidents. After poaching, railways and roads were responsible for the most leopard deaths, 16% or 35, over the first 4 months of 2019. As infrastructure projects were allowed in leopard habitats, deaths by train or vehicle rose steadily. 41 in 2014, 51 in 2015, 51 in 2016, 63 in 2017, and 80 in 2018. Another instance is the rise in leopard deaths as more Indians are connected to the electricity grid. No doubt, infrastructure projects are important for a developing country, but mitigation measures are required to protect leopards and the forest they represent. These protections are being whittled away as pressure grows on governments to open more wild areas for human infrastructure and modernity reaches rural areas. The fast-tracking of such developmental projects threatens India's last wild areas, the country's water resources, and hastens local and global warming. Protected areas provide vital ecosystem services, They are the last repositories of valuable biodiversity, serve as watersheds, and help mitigate climate change by sequestering carbon. Each infrastructure project takes its toll of leopards, other wildlife, and their habitat. Currently, every day, 21 kilometers of roads are being laid across the country, and soon this is expected to reach 45 kilometers, with many of these roads in or around our protected areas. Another cause is death by electricity. The increase in electrification nationwide was correlated with an increase in leopard deaths by electrocution, which rose as a proportion of all leopard deaths from 0.9% in 2017 to 1.2% in 2018 and to 2.3% over the first 4 months of 2019. According to the WPSI data, which could be conservative estimate also, many wild animals are killed when villagers tap overhead power lines to fence fields. Many wild animals are killed when villagers tap overhead power lines to fence fields to protect incursions from herbivores. Not even a tenth of these cases come to the light. Since leopards are protected animals, people are scared to report such incidents. And also bodies are easily disposed because leopards are smaller than tigers or lions. Other animals have been similarly killed. For instance, power lines strung across the last habitat of the great Indian bustard in Rajasthan Desert National Park have been an important reason for the death of a powerful bird, now extinct across 90% of its original subcontinental range, as reported by India Span in January 2018. As forests recede or are split by power lines, railways or roads, the leopard's capacity to adapt often takes it closer to human settlements in search of food. India has world's highest livestock density, so leopards forced out of forest find relatively easy access to prey. Since leopards are smaller than lions and tigers, they adapt to living near humans. Leopards routinely turn up in villages, towns, and cities as large as Mumbai, which contains within it a national park with 47 leopards. Leopards have wandered into houses and schools, gated colonies and government offices, and been found under buses. But we cannot turn blind eye to the whole situation. We need to do something about it and do it now, without further delay. The key to saving leopard lies in preventing human-leopard conflict. That means better management of garbage, compensation for leopard attacks, and providing mitigation measures for wildlife when planning infrastructure projects. Another way of preventing conflict is to manage garbage near leopard habitat. Garbage attracts dogs, pigs, and livestock, providing more food for leopards and increasing their population at a greater rate than in undisturbed natural ecosystems. Accounting for wildlife when planning infrastructure projects is something governments rarely consider. But there has been some reported changes in Maharashtra. There is the case of at least 7 infrastructure projects proposed around the Tadoba Tiger Reserve in Chandrapur district in Maharashtra, where the Wildlife Conservation Trust worked with the State Forest Department to suggest mitigation measures, such as constructing underpasses in the areas where the animal crossover is high, providing chain line fences on either side of these underpasses to guide the animals to them, and providing sound barriers on the bridges to protect the animals from vehicle sound and light. A state committee has asked all road projects between Mumbai's Sanjay Gandhi National Park and the Tungareshwar Wildlife Sanctuary outside the city to be considered together and elevated to allow unhindered movement of wildlife. Another example is the construction of around 10 underpasses on a national highway around 2 years back, cutting through the Painch Tiger Reserve. The management and protection of wildlife, including leopard, is primarily the responsibility of the concerned state and union territory governments. Leopards are not easy to count, since they range across India and many are outside the protected areas. However, the tiger census conducted in 2014 provided rough estimates of over 12,000 leopards as they were spotted during the camera trapping exercise conducted for the tigers. Meanwhile, the National Board for Wildlife cleared 519 projects in India's protected areas where commercial exploitation and construction activities are prohibited and strictly regulated by law, and their eco-sensitive zones over the 4 years of the National Democratic Alliance government between June 2014 and May 2018, as reported by India Spent in September 2018. Also, one must not lose faith. The beauty of our country is that we are a very old civilization and we share a cultural relationship with our animals. We are culturally open to their presence with good conservation practices. We have seen the numbers of big animals like tigers and lions increasing over the years. This makes me believe that the leopard will also bounce back. We only need to do our bit to prevent conflict. Thank you.